Finally tonight, a story of art and war, past and present. Jeffrey Brown reports.
8 a.m. on a cold winter morning at the Marine Corps base Meyer Henderson Hall in Arlington, Virginia. Not a typical time, place, or audience for a classical Greek drama.
You see what I have done. I was the bravest in battle, never lost my wits.
In fact, this performance had a very special goal, to link ancient and modern warriors in an understanding of war's pain and mental agony.
Ajax, Ajax, my name is a sad song. Who would have thought it would someday become the sound a man makes in despair?
The Theater of War is the brainchild of writer and director Brian Dorries, who studied classics in college. His insight that a theatrical experience can help unlock the inner grief and suffering that many soldiers bring back from war zones.
Theater will give permission for people to see themselves in an ancient narrative and then be made to feel less alone by that.
I'm afraid things will soon get worse. Did you
The concept is simple. Four actors read scenes from plays written in the 4th century BC by Sophocles, who not incidentally had himself been a general in the Athenian army.
Let them steal my arms now!
In Ajax, set during the 10-year-long Trojan War, a great hero loses his mind and slaughters animals, thinking they're men, before taking his own life. At one point, his distraught wife describes him in terms that sound eerily familiar.
For our fierce hero sits shell-shocked in his tent, glazed over, gazing into oblivion. He has the 1,000-yard stare.
Don't go.
In Philoctetes, a wounded soldier has been left behind by his army and despairs alone.
I am wretched, afflicted and alone, with no one to talk to. I have no friends.
After the reading, panelists discuss what they've seen, and the audience, soldiers, family members, healthcare workers, are encouraged to speak up. Dory says he knew he was onto something at the very first performance in San Diego in 2008.
It was a very frightening experience for me. I mean, here I was with these actors from New York and LA. We were up on stage reading Greek drama to, you know, 400 Marines and their spouses and chaplains. And we scheduled a town hall meeting to go on after the performance, just thinking that maybe a discussion could be had. And when we scheduled for 45 minutes, lasted over 3.5 hours. And there was a certain point in the evening where I had my aha moment, where I saw almost 50 people lined up at the microphone with comments. And each person who came up to the microphone quoted lines from the plays.
Indeed, while stress in battle is not new, it's become a major problem in today's armed forces. According to a 2008 RAND study, some 300,000 Iraq and Afghanistan veterans suffer post-traumatic stress or major depression. And on the very week we watched a theater of war performance, the Department of Veterans Affairs reported that between 2005 and 2007, the suicide rate for male vets between 18 and 29 had jumped 26%.
Yes, you could term this an epidemic. It is a crisis of enormous proportions. And as such, it is receiving that level of emphasis and attention.
Brigadier General Laurie Sutton, a psychiatrist who heads a Defense Department Center on Mental Health and Brain Injuries, attended an early performance of Theater of War and saw it as an effective tool.
For years, there's been the concern, you know, oh, if I mention suicide to someone who's in crisis, maybe that'll plant the idea, maybe that'll lead them to suicide. Well, we know now, the research has shown time and time again that nothing could be further from the truth. In fact, it's a relief to be able to engage.
Yes, ma'am.
What really hit home for me was a U.S. soldier, say probably 2-3 months into my deployment, came in, and I had to physically, me and another sergeant, physically clean him with our scrub brushes that we use to scrub our hands before surgery, pick the wood out of his face to see.
After a recent performance at the Walter Reed Army Medical Center, retired Staff Sergeant Katisha Smittick described watching a fellow soldier die. She'd been treated for PTSD here after serving in Iraq and said the play hit home.
I guess that was the part that really shocked me, just because I'm like, this is something that happened so long ago. How could they feel the same thing that I felt right now? It's so obvious to see someone without a arm or a leg and missing an eye, and automatically we feel very symptomatic for those people. But you never know what someone's going through on a mental basis. And because you don't want anyone to know, that's the deepest hidden secret that you could ever have.
Marine Sergeant John Eubanks, wounded in both of his two tours of duty in Iraq, hit bottom after returning home.
Ended up being a little self-destructive. Was big on the alcohol, ruined some relationships, work suffered. And it took a while before I figured out that this was not good. And it took some intervention from some good friends of mine to tell me, hey, you gotta get help and get going.
Is it hard for Marines to admit that they have this problem because it feels like weakness?
A little bit. A lot of it is you just don't realize it. You don't relate it to combat, because all these problems typically come when you come back. And you sit there and you're like, well, this can't be from the war. I mean, back home, it's supposed to be the easy part.
I definitely relate a lot to both Philoctetes and Ajax.
Eubanks was so moved by the theater of war experience that he now joins in panel discussions and works with General Sutton on these issues.
We go from Iraq to Afghanistan.
Another Marine who's embraced the theater of war is Sergeant Major Ronald Green, with 26 years of service, including in Somalia and Iraq. He now sits on a Department of Defense task force on suicide prevention and said it was the story of Ajax that hit him hardest.
In the end, when Ajax committed suicide, when he went out and killed himself, you know, I think over and over and over again, for every suicide that we have, I try to relate to what was the last moment in that Marine's life. What were they thinking about? What made them feel hopeless?
Now tell me how you smeared your sword, plunging it deep into the men you came to hate.
I hate to brag.
For the actors, too, this is a new and sometimes transforming experience. Bill Camp, a Broadway and film veteran, and Tamara Tooney of Law & Order SVU, said it was they who were moved by the audience.
You can see them, you can feel them, you can hear them, and it's almost more exciting because I feel that, anything can happen, really.
There is a dynamic in the room that is different when the room is full of veterans.
You can feel it.
You can feel it. And then there are those that actually come forward and listen, and the room changes then.
Without you.
The Department of Defense has provided funds so the Theater of War can visit 50 military sites over the next year.